The signs are everywhere, on the roads and across the land. This high rainfall zone north of Albany is part of 3 million hectares across Western Australia's southwest agricultural region prone to waterlogging. And this year's rainfall is well above average.
On the eastern side of the membership zone, some members have had up to 800 mils of rain since August last year. And some of that land is actually 25% underwater. And then obviously on the western side, there's waterlogging as well and yellow patches, as we can see in the paddock behind.
The yield effects of unmanaged waterlogging can be significant, including soil structure decline.
It can create issues around nutrient deficiencies or toxicities within the plants as soil conditions become anaerobic without free oxygen within the soil. And that ultimately ends up with yield penalties and either reduced yield or complete yield loss.
Contour banks are routinely used around this region to remove surface water, but GRDC's subsurface drainage trials west of Cranbrook aim to offer growers an additional tool to help manage the effects of waterlogging.
What we're trying to do is we're implementing subsurface drainage, which is a process of burying a pipe at approximately sort of that 500 mil down and more. And we bury that pipe with like a chainsaw type machine, and it digs a trench in there, drops the pipe, and then we put a limestone rubble over the top and then cover it up with a bit of dirt. And what we're trying to do is we're trying to look at the economics behind implementing subsurface drainage. We want to be able to determine what that return on investment is and is it actually effective.
A big advantage of subsurface drains is that machinery is able to traffic over them, freeing up spraying operations and improving productivity.
It has definitely relieved the pressure in the areas of the paddock that we've put it in. It's traditionally been the wettest part of that paddock, and we've had trouble with traffability in the past, where so far this year it's definitely a long way in front of what we considered it used to be. So this is where the pipe's laid. It comes from the creek up, all the way up, and then it's got a number of spurs off going to catch the water as it comes down on different profiles and from different layers of the land on the slopes.
Surveys show growers believe it might take up to 3 years for an investment return on subsurface drainage, which can be expensive to install, depending on soil types and how far apart pipes are laid. But the Preston family installed just over a kilometre of pipe in February with immediate effect.
Massive amount of water coming out.
It's good, isn't it? The contour drains are very good at getting rid of surface water, but in summer they're quite often dry. We installed this drainage in February and it hasn't stopped since. There's always been a drip to a trickle to gushing out the end of the pipe since. So it shows you with a drain that is completely dry, an open drain that's completely dry, it's not a dressing that subsoil, where in the subsurface drainage is relieving that pressure, you know, all year round, which I think is great.
Comprehensive data monitoring of the drainage system is being recorded via satellite imagery and on-site weather stations, which help to monitor plant establishment and biomass, as well as weed and disease pressures.
And also leaf wetness over there to monitor disease risk,
yep,
and make sure that at the end of the day, this crop is doing the best that it can.
Growers are encouraged to consider subsurface freshwater drainage in conjunction with other waterlogging management techniques. It's also important to check regulations and approvals with your local government authority before embarking on any drainage solutions. But the subsurface trial, in its first of 3 years, is already returning promising results.
We are hopeful that we'll get a great result out of it. We've already got members investigating it, potentially, you know, implementing it as early as next year, based off what we're already seeing here.
Stillings to Coast farmers are producing project publications on the trial and offering field walks through areas where subsurface drainage is installed.
It's not something you'd want to do just for a 1 in 10 year event, but if you've got areas that would be wet consistently, I think it's definitely worth looking at, and definitely so far I think it would be a good investment to consider.